Seems like all I could see was the struggle. Haunted by ghosts that lived in my past. Bound up in shackles of all my failures. Wondering how long is this gonna last? Then you look at this prisoner and say to me, son, stop fighting a fight, it's already been won. And I am redeemed, you set me free. So I'll shake off these.
You guys will stand with us.
Good to have everybody with us this morning. We hope everybody had a good Fourth. We're glad that you made it back with us, and thankful to be here today. We've come out for one reason this morning, and that's to lift up His name, to give Him thanks, and to give Him praise. I know everybody has a lot of stuff that's going on in their life right now, things we think about from yesterday or things that we're anticipating tomorrow. This is the time that we draw close to Him. We pull ourselves aside from the battles that this world has to offer. We get to enjoy His presence. We get to be strengthened by His presence and get to lift up His name. So don't let this time pass in vain, but make the full use of it and enjoy it. Enjoy being here with one another and enjoy being here in His presence. So bow your head and let's go to the Lord in prayer this morning. Heavenly Father, we come to You and we thank You for this time. We thank You, Lord, for the opportunity that we have to gather together and to celebrate and to worship and just to enjoy Your presence among us. Father, we know that You love us. You've proved it time and time again to us. And most, uh, most of all by the giving of your Son, so that we might have life and have life abundantly in you. And Lord, today we gather together and we choose to celebrate. We choose to lift up your name. We choose to rejoice with all that's going on in our lives and everything that's going on in the world today. We still have good reason to rejoice, and that's you. And Lord, this morning as we step away from everything that's going on in the world, we come into your presence. We ask that your Holy Spirit would fall upon this service, anoint these that lead us in worship, and Lord, have your way this morning. And we ask this in Christ's name. Amen. Take just a little bit of time and welcome some visitors that you've not got to welcome yet.
That's never failing. Let mercy fall on me. Everyone needs forgiveness, the kindness of a Savior, the hope of nations. A Savior, He can move the mountains. My God is my He is mighty to save, forever author of salvation. He rose and conquered the grave. Jesus conquered the grave. So take me as you find me, all my fears and failures, fill my life again. I give my life to follow everything I believe in. Now I surrender, now I surrender. Salvation, He rose and conquered the grave. Jesus conquered the grave. So shine your light and let the whole world see. We're singing for the glory of the risen King. Jesus, shine your light and let the whole world see. We're singing for the glory of the risen King. The Savior, He can rule the mountains. My God is mighty to save. He is mighty to save. Forever, author of salvation. He rose and conquered the grave. Jesus conquered the grave. So Savior, Savior, He can move the mountains. My God is mighty to save. He is mighty to save. Forever, author of salvation. He rose and Jesus conquered the grave.
God, we thank You so much for who You are this morning. God, for allowing us just to be here and spend some time with You. God, I pray that as we open up Your Word today, God, You would just speak to our hearts. God, speak to us in a way that would not leave us the same as when we came in. God, we thank You for what You're going to do this morning, and thank You for meeting with us here. In Jesus' name, amen. You can be seated.
We're going to do it a little different this morning. We're going to invite the band back around in just a few minutes to continue leading us in some praise and worship this morning. I actually want our response to be, after we take just a little bit of time in the Word this morning, I want our response to be in worship this morning. So we're going to invite them back around here when we get to the close of the sermon, and they're going to lead us in a few more songs this morning, a few more praise and worship songs. But let me say that it is great to have each one of you with us this morning. Sometimes, you know, worship comes in a lot of different forms, in a lot of different ways. You know, I believe it's Rick Warren that says, anything that brings pleasure to God can be considered worship. The way a parent raises their children, or the way a spouse loves their spouse, or how we respond in church, or our service, or whatever it is, anything that brings pleasure to God is a form of worship. And sometimes worship is the music leading into the sermon sets up for the sermon that's coming, and sometimes we need to respond in worship. So this morning we're going to take some time, and I'm going to share with you just a few minutes, a particular passage that I want to read to you, and then I want our response to be a time of worship together as we come to the close of the service today. And so we'll get to that in just a minute. But the passage that I want to read, the title of it was Were There Not Ten. And I know you may be familiar with this phrase in the Bible. This phrase in the Bible is a place of where Jesus comes across 10 lepers. When He encounters the 10 lepers, He heals all 10 of them and He sends them their way. And the Bible says that the 10 go their way, one responds, and he comes back and he gives God praise for the healing that he has encountered. You know, and a lot of times, or Sunday mornings is a very special time for a lot of different reasons. Let me explain. I don't know about you, but I know week in and week out, it seems like it can be a battle, a spiritual battle. It can be an emotional battle. It's a financial battle. It seems like every week brings us new challenges that we've got to overcome. It feels like that we face this enemy that is absolutely relentless. He doesn't give up. He doesn't quit. Every time we turn around, it seems like he meets us there to tear us down, to beat us up, to tear us apart. And it feels like every day when we get up, we have to put on this full armor of God because we are engaged in this very difficult, very tiresome battle that unfolds. And I don't know about you, but I know in my own life personally, that these battles sometimes can be very long. They're grueling sometimes. They're disappointing sometimes. I feel like we win some. I feel like we lose some. But I know this. If God permits us to make it throughout this week and come back next Sunday, I know between now and next Sunday that there's going to be some challenges that I'm going to have to face and that you're going to have to face. I know that without a doubt. Every day when I get up as a husband in my household and being the spouse that I'm supposed to be, being the daddy that I'm supposed to be, leading a congregation, times of prayer, my own spiritual life, I know that tomorrow is going to present a whole bunch of challenges for me. And over a period of time, I've learned to enjoy Sunday morning so much because what Sunday morning does It allows me a reprieve for just a little while from those battles that we engage in. It allows me just to step away from it, step aside from it, enjoy the presence of God, enjoy the presence of Christ and of the Spirit of the Lord, and just be strengthened by who He is. And so as we do that this morning, if it does more than anything else, it gives me an opportunity to come back and to thank Him for what He has done for me throughout the week. It gives me an opportunity to come back in here on Sunday morning and say thank you for a... We went in this weekend over the 4th of July holiday. We went in Wednesday night, and we got back Friday night, and we got to spend time with my family. Amy got to spend time with her family, and we got to enjoy the kids with their grandparents and with their aunts and uncles and cousins, and it was a blessing. We were out in the rain some, and we got soaked some, and we had a lot of good food, and we had a good time together. And this Sunday morning presents more than just a worship service, but this is an opportunity for me to return to Him and to be thankful for the good things that He's blessed me with. This is an opportunity for me to return to Him and to be thankful for my parents that I've had, or my dad that I've seen this weekend, for Amy's parents and for her family. It's just an opportunity for me to recognize and acknowledge the blessings that God's given me, acknowledge the good things that He's done in my life, and it's a time for me to come in and to say thank you for what He's done and just give Him praise for what He's done. And that's why I want to read this passage, and this is why we're going the way we're going this morning. The reason that we're going to read this passage this morning is because there were 10 that was healed and only one returned to say thank you. Now, God didn't demand them to come back and say thank you. Jesus didn't say, after you receive your healing, come back and say thank you. After you've received your healing, come back and give praise. Or after you've been touched and a miracle's been done in your life, He didn't say, you must come back and give me praise, because praise is something that needs to voluntarily come from our heart. It's not something that can be commanded. It's not something that can be demanded. It's not something, I don't want to go up to my wife and demand her to say that she loves me. I want that love to come from a choice that she makes from within, from her own heart, that fills up to the point to where she has to verbalize this love. And so our worship service is that. It's not something we demand. It's not something that we command or God commands or demands out of us. It's something that He wants us to voluntarily choose to do. But the sad thing is this, is that there are masses that have been touched by Christ. There are masses of people over this weekend and over the past week and that have been blessed in such wonderful ways. And so many of those people will go on their way. They'll never give God a second thought. They will never give a time of praise or a time of worship a second thought in their mind. They will be the nine that keeps going their way and never looks back. They will be the nine that continues on their journey and never thinks about what God is doing for them or what God has done for them or the miracle that He's unfolded in their life. And personally, I don't want to be a part of that mass. I don't want to be a part of that group that continues to live their life and doesn't acknowledge the things that God has done in their life. I don't want that to be me. So I want to read this story to you, and I want you to listen close. And the way we're going to close this morning when we get to the end of the sermon is we're going to close with a time of worship. We're going to close when we get to voluntarily say thank you, either through prayer at the altar, through a time of singing, whatever it might be. Just letting somebody know that's with us this morning how much we love them, how much we care about them, how much we thank God for them. Let me read this story to you real quick. Luke 17:11-19 says, "Now it happened as He went to Jerusalem that He passed through the midst of Samaria and Galilee. Then as He entered a certain village, there met Him 10 men who were lepers who stood afar off. And they lifted up their voices and said, 'Jesus, Master, have mercy on us.' So when He saw them, He said to them, 'Go show yourselves to the priests.' And so it was that as they went, they were cleansed. And one of them, when he saw that he was healed, returned and with a loud voice glorified God and fell down on his face at his feet, giving him thanks, and he was a Samaritan. So Jesus answered and said, 'Were there not 10 cleansed? But where are the 9? Were there not any found who returned to give glory to God except this foreigner?' And he said to him, 'Arise and go your way. Your faith has made you well.'" There's a couple of things that stand out in this. Number one, all 10 have a miracle performed in their life. All 10 get touched by his hand. All 10 of them receive what he has to offer, but only one returns. You know, if you were to watch our Sunday mornings or Sunday nights, or if you were to watch the ones who maybe gather together or the ones who take time to give thanks, you would think that God's not doing a whole lot in the world today. You would think that there's not a lot going on from the Almighty, that people aren't being healed, or they're not being touched, or they're not being strengthened, or they're not being given ways out of difficult situations. Or you would think that not a whole lot's going on. But according to this passage that we've read this morning, everybody has been blessed to one degree or another. Everybody has seen miracles unfold in their life to one degree or another. But not everybody voluntarily chooses to give him thanks. We get so wrapped up in the things that just don't matter. We get so wrapped up in the things that doesn't seem to amount to a whole lot, while in the meantime, the big blessings that God's give us, the wonderful things that he's done for us, we let them go without a simple thank you. We let them go without a time of praise. We let them go as if it was no big deal and we deserved it and we did it ourselves. The Bible says that every good gift comes from above. You know, this weekend we spent time at my sister's place for a little bit, and we went out to the lake, and Mark has this jet ski and this inner tube on the back of it. And if you'd have told me going in that me and my 62-year-old daddy would be strapped to the back of this jet ski riding this inner tube, I would have said, "You've lost your mind." But we were. There was a particular time where Mark bet we couldn't hold on, and not to be outdone, we can hold on. So he put us on the back of that inner tube. He zipped us out to the middle of the channel and dumped us out in the middle of the channel is basically what it amounted to. And there was a particular time there, we got back in, and I was sitting there, and I was watching, and, you know, and there was a, Daddy had a big old smile on his face. The kids had a big smile on their face. We enjoyed one another. You know, and the Bible says that every good gift comes from above. Well, you know, I don't want to take those good gifts for granted. I don't want God to think I don't appreciate the blessings that he's given me. I don't appreciate the little voices that ring out in my house when they're either angry or happy. That I don't appreciate the blessings that he's poured out upon me. And the best thing that I know to do to let God know that we're thankful for what he's done is to let praise voluntarily come from our hearts. He's not commanded I return and say thank you. He's not demanded it. But as one that loves us, it's the best way I know to let him know how thankful that I am for him. The masses are living their life without a second thought to what God is doing for them in their life every day. That does not have to be us. That does not have to be us. The one thing I love is a lot of times throughout the Bible, when you see some of these people get their healing, when they get their healing, things come out of them that would never come out of them before. You know, they begin to cry out his name. They begin to follow him. They begin to commit their life to him in such a wonderful way. And all of it results from their response to a good thing that God has done in their life. There's not a doubt in my mind that you've got some good things in your life. I know of one just off the top of my head. I know of a great thing that God's given you, and that's his son that he has given you so you can have eternal life and so that you could live in him. This morning, I want to know, have you taken time to say thank you? Have you taken time to return to him, to lift up his voice, and to be thankful for who he is? Yeah, well, there's a lot of hard things in our life, no doubt about it. There's going to be days ahead, and there's been days in the past when we woke up out of bed and maybe didn't feel like putting one foot in front of the other. There's going to be hard days at work. There's going to be financial situations that roll up in people's lives. There's going to be sicknesses that come into our lives. There's no doubt about that. But today we've returned to give him thanks and to give him praise simply for who he is and for the good things that's unfolded in our life. I know this. I know as a father, very few feelings rival the feeling of having your child appreciate what you've done for them. There are very few feelings that rival that. A simple thank you and I love you, or some type of action to where you know they're thankful for either the sacrifices you've made or the gift that you've given or whatever it is that you've done for them. There are very few feelings that rival that. Very few feelings that rival that. I know some of my most emotional conversations with my own parents is when I tell them thank you or I love you or I appreciate what you've done for me. I can remember when Mama got really sick and it was the last, we were going into the last few days of her life and she was there and I asked her, could she hear me? And she responded that she could hear me and that she could shake her head. And I took just a minute, and it's sad that we get to that spot. It's sad that we get all the way to that spot before we say how much we appreciate what somebody's done for us. I told her how much I loved her, what a great mother she had been, and how much I was thankful for her and for Daddy and for all the wonderful things they had done for us. I don't know why it's so hard sometimes to say thank you. Why is it so hard to let somebody know how much you love them and care for them? This morning, we've gathered here today to return to Him and to say thank you for what He has done for us. Now listen, don't let stuff get in your way. Don't worry about who's around you, in front of you, behind you. You're not here to thank them, you're here to thank Him. You're not here to praise them, you're here to praise Him. You are His, and He has blessed you in a very personal and a very real way. And if you want Him to know that you appreciate that, the best thing you can do is let praise emanate from your heart in a voluntary manner. I mean, just because you want to, not because you have to. So this morning, the way we're going to close out this morning is we're going to have a word of prayer. We're going to invite the band back around. And I want you to say thank you in whatever way you want to do it. If you want to sing along with the band, sing along with them. I would encourage that. I'm sure they'd appreciate that. If you want to spend time at the altar in a very personal way saying thank you, spend time at the altar just by saying thank you. If you want to thank Him for people in your life, let those people know that might be here with you this morning. Let them know that you're thankful for them, for the help that they've provided you, for the strength that they've given you, for the prayers that they've prayed for you. If you want that to be the case, take time this morning. The world is going to unfold before us tomorrow, and new challenges are going to be there, and the battle continues tomorrow. But right now, for the next 30 minutes, for the next few minutes, we get to return to His presence, and we get to say thank you. Don't throw that away. Don't act as if we've got many more times to come. The masses are living their life without a second thought to what He's doing. We do not have to do that this morning. So what we're going to do is I'm going to have a word of prayer. We're going to invite the band to come on back around. We're going to stand to our feet. We're going to celebrate. We're going to worship. We're going to be thankful. If you want to come to this altar and pray, you're welcome to do so. If you want to go to somebody, tell them that you love them. You worship the way that the Spirit leads you to worship. But more than anything else, with your heart, I want you to say thank you this morning. I want you to praise Him, and I want you to celebrate the good things that He's done for you. Stand to your feet and bow your heads. We'll ask the band to come on back around. Father, this morning, we thank you, Lord, for the time that you've given us this morning. But Father, more than anything else, we thank you for Jesus. Lord, if there's nothing else right in our life right now, if our marriages are in trouble, if our work environment's in trouble, if our finances are struggling, if physically things are bad in our life right now, Father, whatever else it is, we know that we've got Jesus. And Lord, that's enough for us to lift our voices and to be thankful, because it's through His name do we get to overcome. It's through His name that we get to live. It's through His name that we get to celebrate eternal life and a relationship with you. But Father, I know that beyond Christ, there are many blessings that you've given us. And God, I pray that this time don't pass away in vain. God, I pray that this time doesn't pass away with people looking a different direction. That it doesn't pass away with our minds and our thoughts about something that's going on tomorrow or something that we're going to do later on, Father, or something that's bad that's happening in our life. But God, I pray right now that your Spirit would wrestle with our hearts right now. And Lord, during a time of thanks, during a time of praise, we pray, Lord, that you would receive this praise offering that we offer up to you. And Lord, for those that are having a hard time getting to that place of thankfulness, for those that are having a hard time to get to that place where they can offer up praise, Lord, I pray that your Spirit would just break that bondage in their life this morning. God, that it would break that thing that's holding them down, that thing that's holding them back, the fear of what others might think, or the fear of not knowing or misunderstanding or not being able to comprehend who you are. Father, I pray that you would just break that this morning through the power of your Spirit, and God, that your freedom would fall upon this place and that your Holy Spirit would lead us in the next few minutes. Thank you so much for these that lead us, and we ask that your will is accomplished in Christ's name. Amen. So in the next few minutes, sing along. I want you to worship. Give him your time. Give him your heart this morning. If you want to pray, the altar's open. If you want to go to somebody, I will invite you to do that this morning. Y'all go ahead.
Lord, I come and I confess, bowing here, I find my rest. Without you, I fall apart. You're the one that guides my heart. Lord, I need you. Oh, I need you. Every hour I need you. My one defense, my righteousness, oh God, how I need you. The sin runs deep, your grace is more, the grace is found, is where you together, together, waiting here as one. Oh, 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 hear the sound from heaven. Oh, 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 a mighty rushing wind. Oh, 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 we're calling for revival. God, let your fire fall again. It's burning in my soul.
Just
to leper spots and melt the heart of stone. Jesus paid it all to him I owe. Sin had left a crimson stain.
Get them to do one more, pick up whichever one y'all want to do. And what we're going to do is, you know, some of the greatest blessings that we need to be thankful for are some of the people that God has placed in our life. And God has placed some wonderful people in our life with that's helped us out in tremendous times of need, that have been sources of encouragement and inspiration to us. And so we're going to ask them to sing one more song, and I want you to find somebody Somebody that has been an inspiration for you, somebody that you're thankful that God has placed them in your life, and I want you to go to them and let them know that you're thankful for them. I want you to let them know that you recognize them as a blessing that God has placed in your life from Him, that they've been there in times of trouble, they've helped you out in times of need, or they've just been somebody that you've looked up to or a source of inspiration in your life. So don't let this time pass without letting these people know how much you recognize them as a blessing from the Lord. So we're going to invite them to sing one more song, and as they do, make your way to somebody, to anybody, and let them know how much you're thankful for them and how much you appreciate them. All right? Y'all go ahead.
Beginning and the end, beginning and